While most of the economy was deep in recession, British computing was a miraculous exception. A manufacturing industry that wasn't sacking everyone.
If it's got a keyboard, a manual and computer written on it, it'll sell. That's the word around the exploding market for personal or home computers that simply plug into a television set.
We're the world's largest producer of computers. We make more than the whole nation of Japan put together.
Technological innovation had met 80s entrepreneurialism. The perfect mix for a leader who was a science graduate as well as a free market evangelist.
Prime Minister, this is a small home computer.
The Sullivan Barnes family are going to experience microcomputer mania. So the tech team needs to check up on the choice available in 1982. Gia's come to meet Simon Webb from the National Museum of Computing.
We've got about 3,000 items in the collection.
From this vast array, they select a few models of the right vintage. Some faded rapidly into obscurity.
There's a Dragon there, Dragon 32. This was a Welsh company that produced this.
Others, however, found their way into millions of homes.
What made a machine successful was the availability of software, and this is where machines like the Spectrum sort of won out, because there were a huge number of software titles available for it.
The Spectrum's main British rival was made by Acorn. Although it cost three times as much, it had heavyweight backing. The BBC branded it, and the government paid for one to go into every school in Britain.
So I suppose the main issue with early 80s computers was that none of them were compatible.
That's right. This was what really was unsustainable. Everybody doing their own thing. So it wasn't until the IBM PC really sort of established a standard that all these machines started sort of dying out, you know.
Navigating a path through such incompatible hardware was often tricky. But the Sullivan Barnes family will have to make this tough choice, just as early 80s consumers did. Gia set up a computer fair for them.
This is the astonishing new ZX Spectrum, full 8 colours sound generation, high resolution graphics.
High resolution.
Okay.
All of these machines had much less memory and power than a modern mobile phone at a much higher price. Even the cheapest Spectrum cost over £300 in today's money. While the model the BBC kept plugging would have set you back a whopping 900 quid for 32K. Gia's invited some guests to help the family decide. Simon Munnery is now a professional comedian, but in the 80s published software for the ZX Spectrum.
It still works. How do you stop it?
Patrick Bossert preferred the BBC Micro. He wrote a book about programming when he was a teenager, as a follow-up to his bestseller, You Can Do the Cube.
You're a whiz kid in this area. Now, what's happening here?
Well, you're controlling a car. It's a racetrack.
Ah, then you've crashed.
I think you should buy the BBC computer because you'll have a lot of fun out of it. It's got tremendous games, but when you get bored of playing the games, there's so much more you can do beyond it. Things like word processor and good software just for doing letters and business stuff.
I recommend this Sinclair ZX Spectrum, partly because it's cheap and so many people have it, and there are so many people out there writing games for it.
The Spectrum's very good fun for games. It's effectively a toy.
The BBC computer, it's got the stench of school about it. But most of the games will be fun with counting or isn't geography nice, that sort of thing. So much better to stick with Sinclair, have fun, and let education worry about itself.
Simon's Spectrum is definitely sounding cooler. But Patrick wins back the family's attention by demonstrating some of his old programming skills.
And when you tell it to run that.
What he's written is basic in both senses of the word. But it's enough to intrigue the kids.
It's simple stuff, but it's worth a go.
All right, guys, I brought you here to choose one computer. Which one do you want to choose?
BBC.
Which one do you want to choose?
BBC.
Which one?
BBC.
It's your decision.
I was going to say the BBC, actually.
I'm really surprised, because in the 80s, kids really just wanted the Spectrum. And it was kind of seen as being a bit, you know, swotty to have the BBC Micro. But look at Hamish, he's not even paying attention to this. He's just programming.